Yeah, you know, this is an area that I actually, like every other research idea that I've ever, frankly, approached, it really came from speaking to patients. And I was always curious why it was that despite the fact that at least on a PHQ-9 score, the patient's in remission, but yet the patient continued to have difficulties in one or more domains of function. And when I was going through medical school, I wasn't taught that all symptoms are not created equal. I was taught they're all created equal, yeah, and just get rid of the symptoms equally and life would be back to normal.
Yeah.
Well, it turns out that's not entirely the case. And in fact, anhedonia, the absence of pleasure, both anticipating it, experiencing it, and also what we call reward learning. Learning that's reinforcing positive and learning that's less reinforcing of negative is all part of this construct. In fact, anhedonia and cognition in major depressive disorder represent about 65 to 70% of the overall functional outcome in depression. So I call it the LDL cholesterol of depression.
Okay.
So when you fractionate cholesterol, you get a very different risk across the different subfractions. When you fractionate the symptoms or domains of symptoms of depression, they're not created equal. And this is a particularly bad one. In fact, what this is saying is that not only is anhedonia a laggard, but it's weighing heavily on functional outcomes. And when you get it better, that's where the patient really comes back to life with respect to their outcome. So that then provides an interesting, testable, viable hypothesis that if we can laser sharp just come at anhedonia,
yeah,
that would bode no different than just targeting LDL.
Okay, Roger, I got a quiz for you here. I'm going to put Roger on the spot. Roger, you know there's 9 potential symptoms of depression in the DSM for major depressive episode. Hate to do this to you, buddy, but you can only have 2. You can only have 2. What are the two that most correlate with functional impairment? If I could only have 2, what are the 2 I really want to go after?
The 2 that most correlate are the cognitive and the reward symptoms.
Cognition and anhedonia.
Yeah, the most correlative.
There you go.
And so I think that's really a call to action, and it's sort of an unfortunate reality that these are the most common symptoms that we saw in the Conradi slide, that they're residual.
That's right.
So you kind of scratch your head. The patient's symptoms have improved compared to pre-treatment, yet they can't get back to work. They're still being accommodated. They still are on disability.
Yeah.
This is what's holding them back.
Yeah.